Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm here with you to share another train experience from Eluru to Chennai. This time we have traveled in second AC compartment just to give you a good review of how it looks and how the experience is. This is a special train which runs only on Tuesdays, and it is very convenient to get tickets in this train when all other trains are full during festive season and pilgrimage season. The second AC compartment in this train was fitted with a few good amenities like the toilet occupancy indicator, curtains for each and every berth, and cleaner toilets. So let's get into the video and find out our experience. Let's begin with taking a look at the seats provided in the second AC compartment. As you can see, the berths are really spacious. In third AC compartment, we'll be having three berths: the lower berth, the middle berth, and the upper berth. But in second AC compartment, there are only two berths: the lower berth and the upper berth, we call it. But actually, the upper berth is not so high. It's kept between the lower berth and the upper berth that we see in sleeper class. The bed given is also quite spacious and broad when compared to the third AC and sleeper class. You can sleep just like that if you wish, or you can open the backrest and put it down so that it gives you a broader berth. These are the bedspreads given for the second AC compartment. There was a thick black blanket which you can use as a bedspread. You can put it underneath. And the pillow covers were also changed before we could use them. So this pillow was given to us. Each of us will be getting one pillow. There was this face towel which we are not using now, so we've kept it aside. A white blanket was also there, which we usually put on the black bedspread, because the black bedspread is kind of woolen and it might poke us if we lie on them. So we always cover the black bedspread with a white blanket. Each of us will be receiving one bedspread set which will contain all these items. So once after setting up the bed like this, we usually put our baby to sleep. If you need any extra blanket, you can definitely ask the railway helpers, they'll provide you. In my previous videos, I came across a few comments which stated that these bedspreads are not clean, and that when we are traveling with a baby, we have to carry our own blankets, own bedspreads and own pillows. Guys, we travel by train almost every month, and from the time Rayu was born, we've been taking him only by train, and we have always used only the railway items for our child. We don't carry any special blankets or pillows. These were always clean and hygienic, and we are quite happy and satisfied with it. Indian Railways is definitely doing better and better and improving every time. We just have to support them a little. So this is how we usually set up the bed. You need not book a separate ticket for children below 5 years, and they will not get a separate berth as well. So when parents are traveling with their children, if the child is below 5 years, then you can take them free of cost, and you can definitely adjust with the same berth, with the same ticket that you have, because these berths are quite spacious and you can definitely sleep on the same bed with your child beside you. There was a ventilator and a water bottle holder provided next to the upper berths. In some trains, water bottle holders are provided for each berth, but in this particular train, it was provided only for the upper berths. For the lower berth people, you can keep it on the table or on the rack which is provided in the center of the compartment. As you can see, the luggage space and the leg space for us was too good here. It was very spacious. In third AC or sleeper class, you will not be able to carry such hard case boxes or a 30 kg big luggage which we usually carry to airports. It will not fit under the seat, but in second AC compartment, it was very comfortable for us to push all the luggage under the seat. These are the curtains provided in the second AC compartment. As you can see, from top to down, it is a full length curtain, and there will be no gap in between. These are two lights which are provided, and there was one fan which we usually never use because it is completely air conditioned and it was quite cold there, so nobody switches on the fan here. And when it turns dark in the evening, people switch on the lights when they are not sleeping. So these are the curtains, and there were two Velcro presses given for the curtains. So the curtains won't open until you open them. You can just press the Velcro and you can sleep peacefully inside your compartment. Nobody will enter your compartment even for cleaning purposes without asking your permission. The beds were quite soft and comfortable, and it was long enough for a tall adult to sleep comfortably. Good curtains were provided for the windows as well, so that the sunlight does not enter our compartment and disturb us when we are asleep. Looking at other facilities provided inside the compartment, this is a rack where we can keep unused pillows and bedspreads. Next to that is the emergency pull alarm in red color. In case of emergency, you can just pull it down and the train will stop immediately and someone from the railways will attend to you. Just below the pull alarm, hangers are given. Some people like to change clothes during night travel, so you can hang your clothes in the hangers. And for the upper berth, backrest is also given, which is comfortable if you want to use your laptop. There's quite a big mirror at the center of the compartment. The second AC compartment also differs in each train, so the details about this particular train and the cost of the ticket will be given to you at the end of the video. Just below the mirror are the switches for the lights and the fans and the charging points. In some other trains, I have seen 2 or 3 charging points, but here there's only one common charging point and there are number indicators for the berths. There was a long glass window through which you can see what's going on outside, and there were curtains given to cover that window.
Hi, Sulay. Hi. Do you like this train?
These are the side upper berth and the side lower berth. The length of the side upper and lower berths are smaller when compared to the berths on the opposite side, but the breadth is quite the same and spacious. As you can see, a small net for water bottle holder and a reading light is given for the upper berth. The blanket set contains the same number of bedspreads with a face towel. Looking at the luggage space, this space is also quite comfortable and the lower berth is high enough to accommodate huge suitcases. One box accommodates a total of 6 people and the luggage space was sufficient enough to accommodate the luggages of all of them. There are hooks at the corners near the lower berth so that you can put your seat up or down depending on your convenience. And there was a reading light given for each and every seat. You just have to press this button and the reading light will turn on. You can rotate the light according to your convenience. And then if you press it again, the reading light will go off. If you leave the reading light on for 2 hours continuously, it will auto cut off. This is quite a powerful light and you will be able to read your books or use your laptop conveniently without disturbing others when the main light is off. There are light switches and number indicators given at the center of the side lower berth, but there are no charging points given here. So if you have a ticket for the side lower or upper berth, you need to go to the center of the compartment and plug your phone there. This is how it looks like when all the curtains are closed. As you can see, there are separate curtains for the side upper berth and separate curtains for the side lower berth. And there's one long curtain from top to bottom for the other berths in the same box. This is the screen for the side upper berth. It is a single screen. And for the side lower berth, 2 screens are given on both the sides. You just have to close them and stick them together with a Velcro. Now the side upper and lower berths are completely closed. You can sleep without any disturbance.
Are you comfortable, baby?
Baby, do you like this train?
Mama, buddy, jump in the mama.
Do you like this train?
Buddy, jump in the mama.
But it's a big train. You think it's a big train?
Do you want to go fast or slow?
Fast or slow?
the white signal.
It's not a super fast express. This is a special train. So it's great for all other trains to reach their destination in the right schedule, and then this will go last. It's just an extra train.
How much in this panita matirandi?
Put all the coconut oil on Mama's face, and then Mama asks why her face is shining.
This is the entrance door for this entire compartment. On top of this door is the toilet occupancy indicator. This indicator shows toilet occupied status with red and green lights. In this particular train, there was no Western toilet. Both were Indian style toilets, and the lights will change according to the occupancy status so that you need not go and stand outside the restrooms. Opening this entrance door, there is one door to the right which is always open, and the door to the left is always closed. Going into the restrooms now. The restrooms in the second AC compartment are always better than the restrooms in the third AC or sleeper classes. These restrooms are cleaned regularly. They also spray some air freshener here. Though the restrooms were not in excellent condition, since this is a special train, the restrooms were neat and clean to some extent. This is the room freshener bottle. Room fresheners were kept inside this. A fan was also provided, though nobody uses it. Instruction manual was available in Tamil, Hindi and English. And since these are bio toilets, separate instructions were given on how to use this, how not to throw wastes into this toilet. A small ventilation space was given here. I believe if we use these toilets according to the instructions given, then we can maintain it to some extent. A large mirror was provided inside the restroom, and a hand wash was also provided. Dustbin was also present, and the restroom which was opposite to this is of the same type. In some trains, you might find one Western and one Indian, but in this particular train, both were Indian type toilets, so it was the same type. We have almost reached Chennai now. At Chennai, there were two stops, one in Egmore and one in Thambaram. The train stops at Egmore for 20 to 25 minutes, but it stops at Thambaram only for 5 minutes. You can choose to get down at any stop, but for Thambaram, since it covers a little more distance, you have to pay a little more extra. This train stops in between during signals to pave way for other regular trains. You must always expect some delay in these kind of special trains. When we boarded, the train was almost 2.5 hours late, but when we arrived at the destination, the train was just 1 hour late. It almost caught up with the schedule. The total travelling time of this train is 10 hours 36 minutes, which is a little more than the normal Coromandel Express in which we travel from Eluru to Chennai. One second AC ticket costs 1563 rupees, so for two people the total ticket cost is 3126 rupees with a convenience fee for online booking 35 rupees. The ticket cost is inclusive of GST, but it does not come along with food, so you need to order your food separately or bring it from home. That's it for today, guys. Hope the video was informative and enjoyable. If you like this video, do not forget to subscribe our channel and stay connected with me. See you next time with another interesting and informative video. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.